a long time. And I am so sorry, guys. Like, I'm really, truly sorry to those who have really needed me. I'm really sorry that I've been unavailable for a good almost 3 months here. A lot has happened in my life. A lot of really crazy things. And it's followed by blessings. So, as you can see, I'm here. I'm alive. And I'm well. So, for all those haters and those who didn't want to, yes. So, for all those that didn't want to see me here alive and well, ta-da! Oh my gosh, I'm laughing. I just had like a really funny thought in my head following that, because I was like, I'm like a roach, I never died. It's not funny, but because okay, sorry about that. Phone calls are coming in. My day is starting to get cranked up. But so I have to be really quick because I also have maintenance and stuff coming out to fix some things. But okay, so I have to be quick right now, but I'm gonna come back. So I just wanted to share with you guys kind of what's been going on and where I'm at right now. First, I want to give a shout out to Models Garden Skincare. Can you see the flawlessness? Okay, 1 second, it's over the door. Okay, I'm back again. It's interruptions all the time. That's the moral of the story here, okay? The moral of the story is that negative forces don't want me to bring anything to you guys at all. So I'm in a continuous nonstop fight to bring you guys the God honest truth. Okay. So yes, the constant battle to bring you guys the God honest truth. It has been intense. I am going to be as transparent as possible with you guys without giving you guys, too much of things that are needed for the authorities and things like that. But I'll try to keep you guys into getting an idea of what I've been going through. I have moved. As you guys can see, my setup is completely different. I have had to relocate in a very quick, crazy way. I have had a number of crazy things happen. It's a lot. I have struggled for days, possibly a week or more, on how I would express this to you guys and when and all that, and it's just a lot. It's been a lot. I wanted to be able to speak on this. This is my baby. Model's Garden is my baby, and people really wanted me to destroy Model's Garden and to make it go away. And after long thoughts on this, no. I built this with my blood, sweat, and tears. You know, not a fans only, not some sugar daddy or anything like that, but my own blood, sweat, and tears and hard-earned money that I did, even disabled. This is what God gave me. I'm not giving it away. But yeah, I'm not letting it go, and I'm not giving Model's Garden away. I'm not. and no, you can't take it, and no, you can't have it, and no, 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 this is my baby that I built, and this is what God gave me to give to others. So I'm going to continue to do what God told me to do. I'm going to continue to use the gifts that God gave me to bless the people, because that's what he gave it to me for. So no one else can take it or tell me how to use it, because that was what God gave to me for me to use and to help others and to heal our planet, because our planet literally is on the brink of destroying, being destroyed. And if we don't do something about it now, we won't have our world anymore. So to dive into the things that I've had to go through. Okay, first, before I get into that, can y'all check out this skincare? Okay, I was so excited about it because I, 2 months ago, started a scrub, you know, a line that was just about scrubs, and natural scrubs is organic, that's so good on your body and your skin, and I made it with moringa, so it not only gets your body right externally, but also internally, and your skin turns into something amazing. So as you guys can see, this is what it's done. This is what we have now. I'm super excited about it. I'm also giving out samples to everyone that purchased anything in the store. Okay, so again, if you make a purchase, oh, by the way, it has to be over $25 worth of purchases, and that will be given to you. If it's an ebook, then I cannot do that for you. But if it is an actual service where I am meeting one-on-one with you, whether it's Zoom or the phone, then that is something that will be coming directly to your door. If you buy anything else on the site, that will be coming to you as well, and that's complimentary. You don't have to worry about paying for any shipping fees or anything like that. I will be covering all those costs. So yes, please support. And I'm super excited about this journey. I really am. So diving in. Okay, so, oh, and by the way, please understand that I need your support more than I ever have. And this is hard for me because I've never been in a place where I've ever had to ask anyone for help per se, or even, I don't even know how. I'm used to people coming to me and asking for help and needing me in certain ways. So I'm having a hard time being able to be humble in that space of being like, hey guys, I need help too, okay? And my help, it might be different than most other people's things, but in my situation, I'm simply saying that I just need you guys to support me, support my business, anything that you guys can send my way as far as resources, any type of information that could better my situation, I am grateful for that as well. But most importantly, spread the word, get me out there, share. I don't even know how to ask anyone to give me anything because I don't ever do that. But in this situation, I've been depleted. I've been depleted of everything. And I have to start all over and regrow. And rebuild, and I'm a single mom, and I do this by myself. I'm not trying to get choked up moment right now, because I have like this whole thing and this feeling about single moms that really has it struck me in a different way, just because of what I've had to go through and the things I've had to see in this journey these last few months when it comes to moms and single moms. So I get, hits me in the place. But yes, I am not one to ask for handouts at all. But I do ask that you support. And I, you know, if you want to buy something that's $5, $1, I'll take it all, okay? Because we need it. And my little guy, he needs it the most. And I have to rebuild a whole new life for him. Yeah, gosh, there's so much that I have to say. And I'm just asking the God to lead me to just share it as needed and when he wants me to with you guys. But yes, you know, I'm open for it all, you know. Whatever service you guys need, holler at me. I'm going to add some new things on there. For instance, you know, like I said, I'm going to add the body scrub. We have the body oil on there. I'm going to add the different scents, but I'm going tropical since I'm in this new tropical place. I'm doing some things different. I'm changing some things drastically. We're going extremely healthy. As you can see, I've been working out. I've lost quite a bit of weight. I'm on my model list. And super fit is what I'm going for. And happy and fit. I'm also going to add some one-on-ones, more one-on-ones, where you can just reach out to me. And I'm gonna do it based on like a dollar a minute, basically. So however much time you want to spend with me, it's up to you. And you can literally ask me whatever you want to ask me. After going through what I've gone through, I have wholeheartedly come to understand that what I'm doing, Models Garden, was heaven sent. Everything I've ever said, and anything previously, it was from God. God spoke directly to and through me. And God has used me, and other people and other situations have confirmed it for me. As I did it and I felt like this was God and da, 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 da. But no, they absolutely told me that that was what it was. Okay? So just know, anything that you've ever watched, whether it's on my YouTube or my Instagram, I was on the money, okay? I was on the money, and I said what I said, and I meant it, and it was truthful, and it's real. I'm gonna dive extremely deep on my YouTube, and I'm gonna really be really as transparent as I can on there, because I get a little bit more time where I can speak a little bit more freely. When it comes to Instagram, I have to, you know, cut and paste and clip things, but I'll try my best to do that as well and share what I can on Instagram platform too. But YouTube is gonna have to be more of a platform where I can really express to you guys everything and be more detailed, clear of the things that are being downloaded to me from God, and then also what I've gone through. Okay, so now to dive into what happened to me. I'm gonna need you guys to put your seatbelts on, buckle up, because this is about to be a ride. And a ride that I don't think many of you guys could even fathom, could even get on, or would ever want to experience. But this is what's going on in the world. And this has been going on in my world. And I pray to God this is not happening to anybody else. My God. And if it is, I'm sending my condolences. And I'm also saying keep God close, because that's the only way that you're going to make it through. Ain't nothing else going to work but the good old G-O-D. Okay. So, first theme that I'm going to start to share with is the stalking. I have been stalked. It's not baby stalking, not just some random guy that just finds me attractive lurking outside my house. No. I'm talking about gang stalking. I'm talking about stalking everywhere. Talking when I go to the grocery store. Stalking whenever I walk to the park. Stalking when I take my son to go play. Stalking at my home. Stalking in my house. Stalking everywhere that I go. Stalking everywhere. The extremes went so far to my car. Having tracking devices on my car. The stalking, also, like I said, tracking devices on my car. Putting people or kids in my son's class, in his school, to ask him personal questions about our home. My building that I lived in, being also in on it as well, down to the maintenance that were in my home when I wasn't home or whenever I didn't authorize, putting hidden cameras in my home, throughout my home, invading my privacy in its entirety in my home, and my child at that, my child. Following me from my home to every single store I've ever been to me moving out very quickly and leaving, to also being stalked from city to city and state to state. The extremity of it. Oh, don't worry, guys. Oh, I have the receipts. Oh, don't worry. I'll be sharing that with you guys as permitted. The photos, the videos. It's been nonstop, extreme in every possible way. But I have it all. So I have tons of proof. It's been shared at all the proper authorities, and I'll be sharing with you guys soon, very soon. The other thing outside of the stalking, has been, going, instilling my identity. And doing some of the most fraudulent things with my information and social, to the point that in New Mexico and Texas, I'm banned. I don't think I've even been in New Mexico before. So how am I banned from New Mexico? And I never been there. So the extremities went so extreme that people were committing illegal activities with my name in different states. Yeah. Okay, that's just, oh, we're just getting started, guys. I hope you're sitting in your seat nice and well. So yeah, committing crimes in my name, absolutely awesome. Stalking me on the different platforms, my social media, creating fake accounts. I don't know if you guys have followed me and you guys have seen all these sexy naked ladies for Models Garden, but trying to make Models Garden to appear to be some type of sex site or sex whatever, whenever I don't even have sex. Help me to make that make sense. I don't have sex. I've been celibate for almost 2 years. I won't say 2 years because I did have a little slip up. But if I didn't count the slip up, the one slip up, it would be almost at 2 years here. But yeah, my social media, adjusting my followers, speaking negative towards me, towards my followers. I'm sure some of you guys have seen some of the comments and things like that, saying some really nasty stuff about me. Whenever I mind my business and stay to myself and just take care of my kid and play in the garden and share with you guys stuff in the garden, that's pretty much what my day-to-day life consists of. But no, they've tried to make me out to be fans only. So, and I'm not that. So just to be clear, if you guys see anything out there that has my face, my name, or anything attached to it, please send it to me. If it's fans only, anything in that type of fashion, whatever, please send it to me. If anybody has sent you something and requested money from you or anything like if you've paid for anything, and it was in my name and it said it came from me, Monique Statina or Models Garden, please send me that, okay? It's a lot that was going on that I was completely unaware of. Again, I've just been living my, you know, God-given life, you know, rebuilding my health, and helping to share that with others. That's been all I've done and been focused on. So I had no clue of these things that were going on and the level and an extent these people have gone to destroy me and destroy what I've built and my character and everything. So if there's anything that has happened to you, any way that you have been taken advantage of, please send it to me with your receipts so that I can be able to go ahead. Okay, so let me hurry because I have this other little camera that I set up because my ring light is not working. So I've had to do some other changes. So I'm gonna try to be as quick as possible while we still have some light here. But yeah, so anything fraudulent that you guys have that says I did, please send it to me. And I'm really sorry, you guys. I am so sorry to anybody that has been bamboozled by and scammed under my name. I would never do that. That's not who I am at all. And I'm really, truly sorry. So I'm trying my best to get this under control. It's a lot, guys. It's a lot. So that's why I said I need your help. You know, it's a lot. But yeah, so like I was saying, my car was tampered with. Someone messed with my car so that my clutch would go out, and it did on the freeway while I was driving, so that I would crash, but that did not happen. That's one of the things. Again, like I said, I've had the stalking. I've had the people, you know, trying to terribly destroy my character, terribly in so many ways, from my YouTube to my Instagram, stealing my funds on all of these social platforms as well. Again, like I said, destroying my credit. My credit is screwed right now. So for me to be able to move was just the grace of God. Literally, God has been with me because these people worked so hard to take everything from me. And the thing about it that hurts me the most, that bothers me the most, is that you're not taking from me. You're taking from my son. My son. He's the innocent one. He has nothing to do with this. If you don't like me, fine. But don't do anything that hurts him when I am the only sole provider for him. I'm the only one. I don't have any support from anybody else, no family. Like, literally, no one else contributes to me. I do this on my own. And I don't ask for anything from anybody. I've done this myself, and it's not fair that I've done this. I've rebuilt my life. I redid this myself. Disabled. Disability has still not given me anything. It's been over 3 years, and I've still not gotten any help or anything. I've not gotten any payback at all. They literally destroyed my body. yes, I've been rebuilding it, but it's been taking a long time, you know? And the more that I have to work like a slave every day just to provide for us, it doesn't help my healing. I don't bother anybody. So where do people feel like it's okay to do this and go to this extremes? I would never do this. I would never wish this on anyone else. Especially not any children or people. Like, huh? You're not hurting just me. You're hurting my child who is so simply innocent. I'm sorry I had to pause for a moment because I'm getting choked up here and I don't want to be choked up while talking to you guys. Because when I think about my baby and how much of his life has been affected by this and how I can't do as much as I would like to do for him. He wants to play ball. He wants to go play basketball and football and do all these things and activities. But when you hurt me, it makes it hard for him to be able to do things. And it's his right. You're stifling his growth and his ability. It's already bad enough his dad doesn't do his part. And I don't worry about that because I'm like, okay, I'll take care of it. But when you go and do this, wow, you guys really don't like me, huh? But it's okay. You don't have to like me. Because God does. And God thinks I'm pretty awesome. And you know what? I think so too. I didn't understand that evilness and hate ran this deep. I didn't. Outside of the fact of them destroying my character, my credit, my ability to make money, they've been doing witchcraft and black magic and all kinds of other creative, intricate sorcery towards me. Oh yeah, oh yeah. And I'm gonna dive really deep into that, guys. Because I want to help people who might be going through these things and have no idea that this is really happening to you. And you're wondering why certain things are happening in your life and you're like, I don't understand it. You'll be surprised how much evil and witchcraft that people will go towards to control your life, manipulate your life, destroy your life. But you know, in the end, like God says, what the enemy intends for evil, God will use for his good. So, guess what? I now know. So now, all the things that you guys have been doing to me for a long time, and for a nice portion of my life, I now know the truth. And guess what? Not only has it set me free, but I will be setting others too. Had people hiding behind God and, you know, pretending to be pastors and people that are for God. Religion, hiding behind that while doing evil deeds. Hiding behind their badge, their title, their status, their superior position. And hiding behind that while doing some of the most sinister things in people's lives. But one thing I love about God, he exposes everything. He exposes it all. And God said, you know what? I'm going to expose it all to you and show you what's really going on. And he did. Oh, he did. Oh, he did. The way he has woken me up to see things with his eyes. Okay, well, I've lost my little extra light, so we might have to just natural light it. I'm trying my best, but yeah, it's just been a lot of different things going on, a lot of evilness happening, and I never even knew it was to this level. My God, I didn't know. I knew about, you know, witches and warlocks and, you know, in the movies, and they have Harry Potter and things like that. And, you know, it's like, I feel like most of the time, witchcraft and, you know, magic is constantly, you know, talked about in such a fantasy way. You know, you think of it like Disney and like, you know, a castle, and then like Sleeping Beauty, and you think like, oh my God, it's, you know, it's bad, but then it always ends good, right? But yeah, you know, it always ends, you know, with, you know, a beautiful end story. I mean, think about Cinderella, she finds her prince and everything's always just beautiful in the end. And I think we just, you know, entertainingly watch the journey of the bad that happens, but we don't really actually take time to be like, wait a minute, that was some crazy ass stuff right there. That was really mean. That was really evil. That was, wait, what? You know, I don't think we ever really digest the movies properly and actually really consider it being things that happen in really people's lives. Well, I'm here to tell you that it does. And that, I'm getting chill bumps. Say gabashigira. I'm sorry, y'all. Whew, sorry, God just showed up right now, man. Y'all know I'm all about helping y'all. You guys know I'm all about it. And, just knowing that a lot of these bad things that have happened in your life has been due to something like that. I'm going to dive into this stuff more deeper and really elaborate on this stuff so you guys could be able to really get a good idea of how to deal with this and what this is. But you know, when you see someone and they're like, bad things have happened to them or has happening to them, 9 times out of 10 it's someone doing witchcraft. Wow. And then this song came on when the Holy Spirit showed up. Then Jaira came on. Confirmation. Wow. I don't know. Y'all can't feel God like I can feel him right now. But I'm feeling him. In this moment, like, he wants me to do this. This is what he wanted me to do. And he wanted me to share this with you guys. And I want to help free some of you guys who might not really believe in God. And you might not even believe in magic. But I want you to know it's real. And these are the things that have been controlling our lives. Understanding that these orchestrated magic things are what's controlling our world right now. We said, oh, why is that happening over there? Well, guess what? There's someone over here working together, and possibly with a group of people who are doing spell work for that particular thing to happen. And us as believers, if we don't start to absolutely believe that this evil exists and to fully understand it, to pray against it, we're gonna keep having this happen. I know a lot of people, especially when it comes to religion and God, they don't want to have nothing to do with none of that. Don't bring that over here. And I ain't mad at you. I ain't mad at you because I feel you. But for us as believers, in order for us to fight the fight fairly, we need to know what they're doing. Because how are we praying? We're praying ineffectively. If you're praying and you're not able to say, God, I come against this particular thing, this particular person, this particular situation, then how are we going to suppress it and how are we going to counteract it? We need to be able to say, God, I come against this evil person that is speaking negative over my country. Like, God, I come against these negative entities and negative people and groups that are speaking against the demise of my country in America. I come against it right now. That's the proper prayer. Not, Lord, just bless America. God bless America. Okay? He blessing, and we saying God bless America, but we got other people, other groups, other entities saying, curse them, Satan reign, and Satan have control, and push your agendas every day, and more homosexuality, and more taking over, and more molesting our children. Continue, make room, give them way. And we praying, God bless America. And we're wondering why nothing's changed. Ineffective prayer is what we're dealing with. And for those that are in these higher up religious positions, you pastors who collect checks every day from people, yeah. I'm seeing real clear that you guys are part of the problem. Because you, of all, should absolutely know about witchcraft and sorcery, yet you don't share it enough with your people, your congregation. You don't. You don't do effective prayers. No, you don't. No. Because those effective prayers would take you down in your fraudulent ways. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's a new mode today. Because guess what? When y'all decided to come for my life, you woke up the beast in me. Oh, you take everything from me? That's fine. Because you woke up the beast in me. And now we about to really turn up. Oh, y'all wanted to turn up? Y'all wanted to have a party? Okay, we gonna have a party. Let's do this. So, we got a new Mo that's in town. And she's not coming to play. At all. Oh, we slaying. All your evil devices have been exposed. Mm-hmm. And God let me see. He let me get a front row seat to the action too, actually. And you guys were having a field day with the fact that I didn't know. Oh, y'all was having a good old time. Manipulated my entire life because I didn't know. All these different nasty things that have happened in my life was around witchcraft and sorcery and magic and people putting spells and stuff on me and people around me. Oh, and do know, anybody that dips and dabbles in this type of world of spells, witchcraft and sorcery, and putting spells on people and things like that, oh, God's gonna have his way with you. Ooh, He gonna have a good time. He gonna have a good time. Because if you don't do that, you do not manipulate and alter someone's free will. How dare you? How dare you think it's okay to change up the trajectory of someone's life and what they choose to do? That's why God gave us free will. That's why we have the option between good and evil. That's why we have the option to do bad or do good. Because God literally gave us free will. He literally did. He said you could wake up today and be something great, or you could wake up today and lay outside on the street and do nothing. You have that option. And how dare you come and say, well, you know, if they want to, you know, be great, I don't want them to be great. I'm going to change it. What? Huh? Who the F are you? Really? And then the part that cracks me up about this is that it's people that want to control and manipulate other people's lives, but their life ain't but a crack-a-jack box worth. They life ain't nothing but that little, you know, you go in the Cracker Jack box, they got that one little sticker in there, and you stick it, it kind of tastes really nasty, and you just, that's about all you're worth. That's all you're worth. And you got the nerves, you, with the Cracker Jack, Cracker Jack stamp. You got the nerves to try to control somebody else's life and destiny. That's great. Huh? Where do you even get the authority to do this? You're not even ranking anywhere. You're not even on the chart. And you over here trying to control other people's lives. I'm just saying, there's a lot of people in lanes that they shouldn't be in. They don't qualify for it. Nobody signed them up for it. Nobody put them in there. But they're in it. And trying to control things, run things. But guess what? God is in full control. And he about to step in into me. Yes, so. It's so much that I have to say. So, it's a lot. It's a lot of videos I'm probably going to drop because it's so much that has to be said. But I just want y'all to understand what we're dealing with and what's going on our road, and witchcraft and black magic and sorcery and divination is at an all-time high, and that's what's controlling our world and causing us to have so many different things happening that are not good. And we as believers and people that love God and are good on this planet, we have to come together and pray effective prayers and be diligent and really look out for each other, really have each other's back, and really not be afraid to talk about God anymore. I've been going different places and, you know, I talk about God all the time, you know, and people are like, oh, you love God, you know God, oh, hallelujah. I'm like, yeah, you know, you do? Well, why did you not say nothing? You know, and people are afraid. People are scared to talk about Jesus and to say his name. But at the end of the day, all power and authority is in that name. The whole reason why they don't want you to know God, talk to God, speak about God, say God, share God, is because they know that's where the power lies. Do you ever hear them ban any other religion? Do you ever hear them ban anybody else that speaks about anything else? They talk about Allah all day. Don't nobody say nothing. People talk about Buddha all day. Nobody say nothing. People talk, you know, Maria and Santeria and all that other stuff. You know, the Catholic. Nobody says, no, but when you talk about Jesus, ooh, and you talk about the Holy Spirit, ooh, oh, Ben, oh, you can't say that. Oh, we can't talk about God at work. Oh, we can't do, wait, what? Huh? Yeah, that's the whole enemy tactic. To get y'all to get so far away from the one person and thing and entity that could actually protect your butt. So y'all be out here naked and exposed and able to get your butt whooped. Because you're going to get whooped by them. And then after you get whooped by them, then God going to come and whoop you too. It's going to be a TKO for you. So I don't know about y'all. But, you know, even if I wasn't a believer, okay? The fact that this one particular religion upsets everybody, gets everybody mad, this one thing is getting banned and nobody can talk about it. And this is this one religion, huh? And nobody... I'm sorry, that would make me a believer just off of that. Just off of that. Because nobody care about nobody else's religion. You know, the other ones, none existent. No one says anything about Gandhi, Hindu. Nobody says nothing. Nothing. But let somebody talk about Jesus. Oh. It's an uproar. It's got to have some power of some sort. It's got to have something. Because it really got y'all feathers ruffled. Y'all pennies in a bunch. I'm going to leave that right there for y'all to think on. I know one thing's for sure. If y'all believe in God or not, our world is about to be destroyed. So, if you are open to not having a life, a planet to live on, continue on. Don't do anything. It's gonna be over pretty soon. Unless we step in and change how we're doing things and become better people. That's all we have left. That's all we have left. I mean, I don't know about y'all. It's a lot going on. And like I said, our world's being destroyed. I don't even know if we can even fix it or even, but we should try. We should try. But either way it goes, I think our biggest and most important thing to do right now is to get right with God. And however way that might be, I think that is our most important thing to do, is to get right. Get right. Just get right. I don't care what it is, just get right. Whatever you're doing wrong, you know what's wrong. You need to get on the right side of it. Because things are changing. Yeah, things are changing. And things are changing quickly. Very quickly. So quick, we can't keep up with this level of movement here. And whether God is going to come in and start taking everything out or not, I think the most important thing is to be on the right side of things right now. Mm-hmm. I would just say get on the right side just in case. Because I'm just saying, if God pulled up right now and started slaying, I hope you is on the good side so you don't get hit in the crossfire. That's all I'm saying. I know I'm going to be over here on the sidelines watching all the action go down and talking about I told you so. That's what side I know I'm going to be on. I don't even think people really fully understand what judgment means. And many of y'all really pay attention to you at the court, do y'all?
We're talking about the court with the Lord, though. And he going to be judging us not just on that little fraction that you got of that little ticket that you took, you know, that little red light you ran or that. And it ain't going to be that. Mm-mm. He about to examine your whole entire, your whole entire life. Mm-hmm. Your whole entire 30-something plus years. Your whole entire 50-something plus years. Your whole entire 80-something plus years. Woo! I hope you rid your wrongs. I hope you got on the right side. I hope you ask for forgiveness and repentance. Y'all think judges is something. And speaking of judgment, I know this is quite off subject. But something's coming for y'all who made these wigs and this hair glue and these caps and been having us put this stuff on. And I'm taking out all of our edges. Look at my edges. They're gone. Look at this. Gone. Now I gotta put some model garden herbs. Look at that. On it to grow it back. Y'all, and this glue is a devil. They gone. Little rosemary though. Rosemary can fix this. It's gonna take some time, but it's gonna come back. Y'all guilty. And also, these people that's putting this stuff out here in these airs and skies. I'm talking about I've been sneezing. Like it's nobody's business. I ain't never sneezed so much. Nose is running, I'm sounding congested, I'm spinning up loogies 100 times a day, blowing my nose. I didn't even know I could even build this much snot. I don't even think I slept that good last night. That's how much I sneezed and had to get up and blow my nose. It was quite crazy. Like literally. But yeah. Y'all, the Lord about to come for y'all that's sitting here doing this stuff. I mean, really. Edify me, prophesy to me. Come on now. I'm all about some good music. I haven't even listened to no regular music in like a couple months. I've checked out on that. Now I gotta have some music that's gonna make me be like, feel good, you know what I'm saying? Reminded about how good God is and what he can do. Cause we live in times where the rest of y'all is not effective at all. It's not. I can't even enjoy the music anymore. It's not effective. Not effective. I don't feel good. I don't feel good listening to y'all music no more. Okay, so. Now that we've had this little combo here, I'm gonna come back with some more. I just gotta think about what else God want me to talk about and do. I'm gonna upload this video. But I want to go to the beach today. I haven't been to the beach in like a couple of, like I feel like a week. Because I've been having to get acclimated and organized and set up. And I had to put all this stuff together and get my whole little model's garden back. You know, I had to get caught up with so much stuff. And also want to say to my customers and people who put in orders, and I am so sorry of the delays that has happened. I'm so sorry, and I thank you guys for being patient with me and being understanding. And for those who are not understanding, I understand. I know when you want your stuff, you want your stuff.
I get it. So I'm understanding to that too, to those who are understanding. But to those who are understanding and working with me, you know, I'm sending you your gifts, you know, with whatever you ordered, and I'm getting everything out. I'm pretty much caught back up. And I apologize that this whole thing has been this. I had to pack up and move, and I just left, and I ran for my life, basically. So I apologize, but I'm back, and we in here. And I want to give a public service announcement. Please, if anything, make sure y'all share this part and talk about this part, or whatever you need to do. But I want to let people know, just know, I'm ready for you. So anybody coming for me, anybody coming to stalk me, do anything, I'm gonna tell you right now. Y'all ever see the movie J-Lo? I mean, you ever see the movie Enough with J-Lo? You ever see her? Things went down? Yeah. Just know, it's the mini version over here. And I'm ready for whatever. Literally, whatever. I'm just saying that I'm gonna protect myself and my child at all costs. At all costs. So I've already reported everything to the proper authorities. I've come out, I've told you guys, I've said a public service announcement so that the whole world knows that if you come over here trying to mess with me and mine, I'm gonna tell you right now, it's gonna be some bodies. And I'm gonna tell you, it ain't gonna be me and mine. I'm gonna tell you that now. Because, I'm going to absolutely 1,000% protect myself. Okay? And I'm gonna protect and serve myself. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. I'm not gonna wait for the help. And for those who are stalking me, I'm gonna tell you right now. I know who you are. For those who've been doing these things, I know who all of you guys are. Oh, I know. And guess what? I'm telling you right now and today that this is your last day. And if I was you, I would stop today. Because the next time that I encounter this, I'm going to start exposing you guys one by one. One by one. Oh, with my receipts too. So they know it's real. Okay, guys. Well, I'm going to go ahead and continue with my day. I'm going to upload this video and get all this other stuff going, and let you guys know I'm back on social media. I have lots of messages and emails and stuff to get through. I'm going to do my best to try to get through to you all and respond to you guys and all that. I know y'all been sending me all kinds of stuff that's been going on around the world, and I honestly don't know what's been happening, you guys, so please bear with me because I don't know what's going on. So I gotta get caught up to speed myself with what's going on, because I've just been in mommy mode, protection mode, you know, covering mode, making sure we can get to a safe space where we could be safe and in a way. So I've been working on that. That's what I've been doing. So I don't know what's going on, but I'm gonna you know, try to get caught up to speed as quickly as possible with you guys, and then, you know, start dropping my videos again and everything, and just because I got so much to say.
But again, anything that you guys need, any services you guys need, you know, some me time, you just need to talk, you got some questions you need to ask God, you need some answers, hit me up. I could definitely help you with that, okay? Book a session. I'm going to actually try to run some specials for you guys, because I want you guys to be able to access me as much as you can. And not to sit here and say that anything's going to happen to me or anything like that, because that ain't happening. But I'm just saying, I want you guys to be able to get access to me and to be able to get whatever you need from me, you know? I wholeheartedly know what my purpose is here now. I do. And I know that God put me here and allowed me to go through the things I've gone through and put me in the positions that I've been in to help others. That's it, you know? And I've been through so much in life that my experiences go far and wide, okay? And my expertise, just as much. And so whatever I can do to help you with, whether it's your health, whether it's your beauty, whether it's your experiences that you're dealing with, whether it's the spiritual things that you're having challenges with, please message me. You know, please reach out. Please book a session. Again, this is not just helping me or helping you. This is, we're helping each other in this. And do understand that when you reach out to me, you book a session, you purchase anything from me, it is blessing me and my family. And my family is me and my son, but it's blessing us. And, you know, like I said, I have a lot of things that I have to rebuild and redo and fix and pay to get help for. And it's excessive, guys. And again, I'm still slightly disabled, you know? So Models Garden is what I can do in this position right now. Hollywood, I'm still having to wait until God says I can step back. As of right now, this is what God has me doing. And it's funny because I've tried to do some other little different things and it's not been able to pan out the way I would like it, you know? And I truly, wholeheartedly believe it's because God wants me here. He wants me to help heal, help to break some souls free, and to end the pain that so many of you guys are dealing with, you know, that maybe you speak about or maybe you don't. A nice amount of people are living in pain every day and no one knows it. I can relate. But I can also relate to not being in that place anymore. And I want to help you be there too. I've made the decision to fully commit to God and doing what God wants me to do. Like, that's it. Like, literally, that's it for me. I really, really love people. I love God. And I love God like the way I love people. And I love God more, though, because some of y'all people be really, some days, I don't like you people. But for the most part, I love y'all, and I want the best, and I'm committing my life to giving you guys that, and helping you guys in whatever way I can, and I hope you guys can find your peace. So, this is my grand announcement to say, Models Garden is not going nowhere. We are here to stay. And we're back. Thank you so much, you guys, for everything.
thank you for still holding Bottles Garden down while I was away. Thank you for sharing and spreading the words. It means a lot to me. I just want us to all wake up and to realize who we are and who God created us to be. And for us to start to do our part to be better people so that we can get our world back. We need our world back. I love y'all. Thanks for hanging out.